like about them is actually from my school, Virginia Tech, but how one page can begin to convey information. So in this case, there was a photograph of a sketchbook and a finished model. In this case, a project that had a process, an overlay of this typewriter that later became a building. So this was, these were like posters that were pages for a, exhibit. What I like about them, they begin to talk about how graphics and the model begin to overlay over on top of each other for ways of beginning to show the work. And here's a model picture overlaid on top of a graphic drawing. These are actually, each of these are actual boards, single boards, these are like 22 by 22 of the design objects that were made into somehow specific individual pieces. So this is the page, that's the page, that's the page, that's the page. And these were what I call single pages that have, it's not a format that continues throughout the portfolio, but these were pages that each one was its own isolated. It was based on the object itself. This is a different kind of portfolio page. What I would recommend is a format that gives you continuity, but this is a type of portfolio that's specific to the project. So it's, the page is designed specifically around the individual project itself. It creates the format, it creates the design, it creates how I begin to present it. So in a way, like individual posters, individual pieces of art.
Each student took a project and had to present that in the best way. And then these were all collected and made into like a booklet. These are all individual studies. How this drawing was put on the beach. This was a chair design, a section plan. This was a product design of McDonald's over here. And how, again, you can take one piece and begin to see it as its own layout, generate the design.
The other thing is, if you, there's a couple magazines out there. One is called Graphis, the other is Print Magazine. You can go to those and you